A hobby can recharge your life, strengthen your health, and bring peacefulness to a busy world around you. Everyday life can be filled with many stresses and high demands from work or even a household environment. But picking up a hobby and taking time for yourself can be rewarding and beneficial to your health. Today, I'm going to show you one hobby that will boost your health far greater than most hobbies out there. The best part? You don't have to exercise, leave your home, or buy expensive equipment. Some microgreen hobbyists have gone to make this their full-time job, expanding their yields and making a full-time six-figure income from it. I will show you how to grow superhuman food and have fun doing so indoors. This is a hobby to pique your interest, lower stress, and is proven to boost your health. So what's this hobby I'm talking about? Well, it's microgreens. There are over 1,500 types of microgreens, all with different flavors and nutritional benefits you can pick up and grow from. The plants like broccoli, arugula, radish, cilantro, basil, purple mustard, cabbage, sunflower, borage, and many more. I know what you're thinking though, this is gardening. Yes, but at a faster rate. You'll be harvesting these when they're baby microgreens. To keep things simple, when starting out, I will only be discussing one microgreen that takes 8 to 14 days to grow. It's one of the easiest to grow with little effort. I will be talking about growing pea microgreens. This specific microgreen is high in protein, is great for the skin, protects against cancer, infections, and even improves bone health. So what is the microgreen anyway? It's often confused with sprouts, but they are harvested at different times. Sprouts don't have leaves and are considered more of like an embryo stage, and microgreens are baby plants with tiny little leaves. Sprouts do not have much of a taste, whereas microgreens really pop with flavor. They are often more flavorful than the adult vegetables and fruit counterparts. Microgreens are also 4 to 40 times more nutrient dense than the mature plants. That's why I refer to them as superhuman foods. Basically, all these nutrients are cramped in an itty bitty little space. So let's get started. First, you'll need to get yourself a pack of seed sprouter trays and drain holes. You can get a pack of these for about $15. Second, you'll need a bag of seeds. I normally buy either 1 pound or 5 pounds since I know I'll be growing often. I picked speckled peas since the flavor is delicious. You'll need a measuring cup, and I recommend an indoor thermometer to make sure that this is room temperature is appropriate. Normal room temperature ranges from 60 to 75 degrees Fahrenheit or 15 to 24 degrees Celsius. Keep on hand a spray bottle and a container to hold water. You use the spray bottle for the seeds to start them growing and the larger container to refill the bottom trays as the roots begin to develop. Lastly, you will need a container to store your cut greens if you harvest all of that once. I use the plastic packaging from salad containers I bought at the store. The best part about growing this is you will not need any dirt, so no messy cleanup afterwards, since you'll be growing hydroponically using only water. You'll need a grow light and a timer. You can pick up this full spectrum halo plant grow light for one tray, and it includes a timer. Or if you plan to grow more than one tray, I recommend getting T5 LED tube lights and a separate timer. You can attach the tube lights to the shelving units, and then you can grow in a larger space. For each tray, I measure 1 cup of peas and soak them in water overnight. The next day, I pour out the peas and distribute them evenly across the entire tray. It's easy to keep the water in the bottom of the tray at that point, and then it'll soak up the water once those roots have developed. Since these trays are rather flimsy, you'll need to pick these up very carefully so as not to spill the water all over you. Once the peas are in the tray, cover the seeds with 2 layers of paper towel and spray water to soak the towels good. This keeps the seeds from drying out since the roots haven't grown enough to touch the water yet. Place an extra empty tray on top of the wet towels and put some weight on the empty tray. I use books and cover with a large dark towel for 4 days. This is called the blackout period and mimics seeds in the ground, and the pressure helps the roots push downward. On day 4, check to see that the roots are touching the water. If they are touching the water, then you can remove the towel, books, and paper towels and let them grow. Between days 7 and 12, you should have a decent amount of growth. You can harvest them when they reach about 2 inches in length. Growing pea microgreens is easy, takes up little space, is a great relaxing hobby that has numerous health benefits when you eat them. Once you get the hang of growing pea microgreens, I encourage you to explore the vast selection of microgreens to try. Delicious. Hope you try them soon. Thank you.